Hello, my name is Tamara Goldbogen, and I am with the Arts Learning Collaborative, where we support high-quality arts learning experiences at Weber State University and across the state of Utah. In this video, Erin Roundy is going to walk you through some easy steps for completing a visual arts project. You can check out our website at weber.edu/artslearning, where you can find more videos like these and other resources to help you bring the arts into your classroom. Please feel free to share this with your friends and colleagues.
Welcome. Our lesson today is titled Poster Art. The objective of this lesson is to design a poster highlighting one of Utah's three main habitats by implementing key characteristics of Romero Brito's style, with the final product being something like this, a Brito Eyes Utah habitat poster. You will need the following to complete this project: a sheet of 9x12 white tagboard or other heavyweight paper, pencil and eraser, ruler, an assortment of black sharpies or black pens, colored pencils, photo references of geographical elements of vegetation in Utah's three main habitats, desert, forests, or wetlands, tracing or drawing paper. Be sure to check out the description below for the full list of materials. Before we get started, let's first go over the important vocabulary words that you need to know: shape, pattern, and repetition. There are seven elements of art in visual art. They are line, shape, form, space, color, value, and texture. The elements of art are the building blocks used by artists to create a work of art. Shape is one of the seven elements of art. Shape is a closed line. Shapes are flat. Shapes can be geometric, like squares and circles. In this example by Paul Clay, Castle and Son, he shows a variety of different kinds of geometric shapes. We have triangles, we have rectangles, squares, circles. Or shapes can be organic, like free form or natural shapes. In this example by Joan Miró, you can see a variety of different organic shapes that are created. There are nine principles of design in visual art. They are balance, emphasis, movement, pattern, repetition, proportion, rhythm, variety, and unity. They describe the ways that artists use the elements of art in a work of art. Pattern is one of the nine principles of design. It is the repeating of an object or symbol all over a work of art. In this painting by Kehinde Wiley, you can see that he has used this flower motif over and over, creating a pattern in the background and also scattering in front of the subject. Repetition is another of the nine principles of design. It works with pattern to make the work of art seem active. The repetition of elements of design creates unity within the work of art. In this example by Yayo Kusama, you can see that she repeats over and over again the circles, varying the size of them to create a sense of repetition and pattern throughout. She also does the same thing, but with different organic shape in the background. Let's look at Romero Brito's art and identify key characteristics of his style. In this particular painting, you can see that Romero has taken complex shapes such as human figures, insects, other animals, and plant life, and he has broken them down into basic shapes, including both organic and geometric shapes. He has also taken these larger shapes and broken them down, similar to stained glass, into smaller pieces. In this example of a stained glass piece, you can see the similarities between the two, where these larger shapes are then broken down into smaller pieces. Romero Brito also uses bright, bold colors throughout his work, as well as alternating colors from light to dark to create some variety. You can see evidence of both patterns with circles and stripes, as well as repetition, where he's repeating these shapes over and across to keep the work active and alive. Another characteristic of Romero Brito's is the objects or elements he uses to create his patterns. He keeps it very simple and doesn't really go beyond his kind of set of patterns that he uses, such as hearts and stars, flowers, dots and circles, lines, stripes, lines and dots, and especially his signature. Keeping these things in mind, let's get started. You need to first choose one of Utah's three main habitats, which are deserts, forests, or wetlands that you would like to use for your poster design. In your habitat design, I'd like you to highlight key plants and or trees and general landscape, as well as including the name of the habitat in your design. You have been given a list of various vegetation for each habitat, along with some photo references. Because I'm going to be doing the desert for my design, here's my list of desert vegetation that can be found, along with some photos. You can use these to help you decide what images you'd like to use in your design. And of course, you're also welcome to do Google searches for more information and photo selections, which I have gone ahead and found more images of the yucca plant, prickly pear, arches, and sunsets for me to use. Okay, set these aside, and now I'm going to walk you through the steps to create a Brittle Eyes Utah habitat poster. First, take your sheet of 9x12 tagboard or other heavyweight paper, and we're going to put a 1-inch white border on all four sides. Do this lightly in pencil. Once you've put your 1-inch marks in, take your ruler, line up your marks, and again, lightly in pencil, follow the edge of your ruler to create our 1-inch white border. You're going to take your thick Sharpie and you're going to trace those pencil marks, making sure that you don't follow through where the lines intersect, so you're left with a nice rectangle, and then erase the pencil marks where the lines intersected. As you can see from this example, I have already outlined my pencil marks to create my border. And if you can see my lines where they intersect, I can take my eraser and get rid of those so that I can have a nice clean border. Now, lightly in pencil, you're going to start sketching in plants and or trees and general landscape objects, simplifying shapes, similar to how Brito takes complicated images and simplifies them while maintaining enough visual information that the viewer can still identify what they're looking at. Let me show you what I mean by taking more complicated shapes and breaking them into smaller ones. I'm going to do this by using this photo reference of a prickly pear cactus that is commonly found in Utah deserts. And I'm going to take a sheet of tracing paper and I'm going to lay it down on top. What I'm doing right now is just for me to practice, so I get a feel for the shapes that make up this prickly pear and how I can simplify them. By laying the tracing paper on top of the photo reference, I can see the photo reference through it. I'm going to take a Sharpie so that you can see it, but you can definitely do this in pencil. And I'm going to just trace shapes, large shapes that I see that make up this plant. This is a good way to practice and to help you get a feel and sense of what makes up this plant. I'm not going in for details. I'm just looking for basic shapes. Also, because I'm using the tracing paper, it also allows me to pick and choose what areas I want to highlight as well. Okay, I feel pretty good about what I've traced right here. As you can see, when they're side by side, still has the feel of, because there's enough visual information as the photo reference. I do want to come in here and break it up just a little bit more. I notice that the petals on the prickly pear flower, I need to kind of imply those petals. So I'm going to do that just by simply putting some lines to create that. There's also all these little dots on it. And so what I'm going to do with that, instead of counting, and I'm going to give the impression by just randomly putting dots. Now, remembering that Romero Brito is known for alternating his patterns, even though he uses dots, he doesn't always use the same size. He varies them. So I'm going to apply that here by putting larger dots. Again, our objective is to convey the vegetation and the natural landscapes that are found in Utah's habitats, but we're also giving some artistic liberty for interpretation as we apply key characteristics of Romero Brito's style. This also helps give us variety and visual interest. Again, this is just me practicing, getting a feel for the shapes, how to draw a prickly pear cactus in my design, Let me just show you a quick little tip where you can create your own light box to help transfer this to your final paper. So now that I've drawn this, and the fact that I've done in black Sharpie will allow me to see the line work through another piece of paper, I can take my final sheet of paper, and of course right now you can't see it, but I can go ahead and put this up against a window and then put this on top of it and I can see through it. I can then move my tracing paper to wherever I want that prickly pear cactus to be, and I can then trace on top of it. So that's just a really easy way. If you don't feel confident, or maybe you really like how you drew this, then you can reuse it. Getting back to sketching out your design, keep your pencil marks light so you can easily erase. We will be tracing all pencil marks with a black Sharpie, as that is another key characteristic of Brito style, the thick black outline. Here is my final paper. I'm going to go ahead and use my Sharpie to outline my border. I want you to know that I'm going to keep one side of my border free from the Sharpie for right now, as I've decided that I want the title of my habitat, which I'm going to be using desert, to go outside into the border space. But for right now, I want to show you the three sides that I'm going to keep. And looking at my photo references while I'm sketching, I'm going to start drawing in my design. As I explained earlier, taking these complicated shapes and simplifying them into basic shapes, still communicating enough visual information that your viewer will know what they're looking at, is key to making this a successful poster. I'd also suggest that you don't overcomplicate it as well with items that you're going to include. Maybe select three main vegetations that can be found that are common in the habitat that you have selected. Even though we're working with a sheet of paper that is larger than a regular sheet that you're commonly used to, it's still not a lot of space in which to work. And since I'm asking you to include the name of the habitat along with plants and trees and other vegetation, other general landscape that you find, by keeping it simple, you're able to fit it in the space easily. I'm going to continue working on my design, again working lightly with my pencil so that if I need to erase, I can erase and not leave any evidence of pencil marks at all. So I will be back. All right, here you can see that I have put in the rest of my borderline, accommodating for desert, the title of my habitat that exists in extending past. I've also outlined in the thick Sharpie all the elements that I have in my design, including the yucca plant, the prickly pear, and a sunset with an area that I'm going to have as kind of the sand. I've erased all visible pencil marks. I used a larger eraser to do that to make it easier, because I had to cover a lot of area. Now that I'm done, I can start to add in the patterns. We are going to use the patterns that Brito uses in his art, such as hearts, stars, flowers, stripes, dots, lines, and instead of his signatures, you can always use yours. For this part, I like to use either a thinner Sharpie or a more fine tip, like a felt tip or a Pilot G2 black pen to put in my patterns. I do this because it gives contrast to the shapes here versus what's happening inside of them. I personally just draw in the patterns directly using the Sharpie, but if you don't feel confident, you can go ahead and lightly draw the patterns in with pencil, then trace, and then erase any visible pencil marks. So I'm going to get going on adding. Also keep in mind that you want to keep areas that are pattern free too. Brito doesn't fill in every single shape because that allows the viewer's eye a break with all the busyness that is happening. Here you guys can see that I have now added in my patterns. I've used the thin Sharpie to do that. You can see the nice contrast between the thinner Sharpie versus the bolder, thicker outline of the heavier Sharpie. I've included patterns that Romero Brito uses in his, such as the flowers. I've done the line and dot patterns. I've done a variety of different kinds of stars. I've done stripes. I've also played around with dots, using different sizes of dots in my pattern usage. Now we're at the time that we can start coloring. So you're going to get out your colored pencils and you want to select bright, colorful ones. Similarly to Brito, you don't have to use colors that are realistic. You can have fun interpreting, but always keep your colors bold. And also color in areas with just solid color too. Keep areas also color free. Again, to give the viewer's eye a break. I just wanted to show you a little bit of progress as I'm going. You can see that I'm alternating colors. That's another key characteristic of Brito, light green, dark green. I've also thrown in some brighter, warmer colors up here to highlight the sunset. The prickly pear with its pink flower, I've used a variety of reds and pinks and purples to create those colors. So I'm going to continue coloring this in until I've completely done it. Here is my final Brito Eyes Utah Habitat poster. So let's review. The three important vocabulary words that I asked you to know are shape, pattern, and repetition. You can see that I've used a variety of different shapes. In this case, mostly geometric shapes with circles and triangles and rectangles, but I also have a lot of organic shapes that are happening, particularly as you look at these larger shapes right here with my yucca plant. I've also created shapes with my title. I have evidence of pattern, which is a repeating of an object or symbol all over the work by repeating hearts, flowers, stars, lines, my signature as well. I also have that repetition happening, which are helping me to create those patterns. I had complex shapes that I've simplified. I've broken up my shapes to have a stained glass-like appearance. I have black outline. I have bright, bold colors as well. I can't wait to hang this up in my room to highlight the desert habitat here in Utah. Thank you for joining me today. I hope you enjoy making your very own Brito Eyes Utah Habitat poster. Now go and create.